These are the stories making the headlines in the Hot 7 Nightly News.
An activist is asking St. Lucians to break from the culture of covering up for perpetrators of sexual crimes following an eye-opening docu-series on alleged abuse by R&B sensation R. Kelly. Three separate incidents of domestic violence sent women, including a pregnant woman, to the emergency room over the weekend. And it's back to school for students across the island, except Cicero Primary students, due to health and safety threats. The details are coming up in the Hot 7 Nightly News.
This is the Hot 7 Nightly News with Lovely and Amy Joseph.
It is Monday, the 7th of January, 2019. Welcome to the Hot 7 Nightly News. I am Lovely St. Amy Joseph. Thank you for joining us. Monday was the official start of the second term. While most students were back at school, those of the Cicero Primary School were not in attendance. The Department of Education, Innovation and Gender Relations has issued a statement outlining the reason as a precautionary measure to ensure the health and safety of students, staff and the general public. Solange Alfred tells us more.
As schools around the island reopened on Monday, 7th January 2019, most students looked forward to engaging with their teachers and peers for their second term of the academic year. However, students of the Cicero Primary School will have to wait until Wednesday, 9th January to commence classes. A notice sent out by the Department of Education, Innovation and Gender Relations to parents and guardians explained the delay of commencement as, quote, remnants of fumes emanating from chemicals used during repair work at the school, end quote. Hot 7 News took a visit to the vacant institution where the pungent odor of the chemicals lingered and were noticeable from even outside the building. With the strong presence of the odor emanating, it begs the question, when did the repair work commence and when did it conclude? The Ministry of Education noted that this precautionary measure looks to ensure the health and safety of the students, teachers, and other members of the public visiting the school. An apology was also issued by the Department of Education for any inconvenience caused. Reporting for Hot 7 News, I am Solange Alfred.
Thank you, Solange. The St. Lucia Fire Service had its hands full over the weekend. Sources revealed to our news team that the issue of domestic violence was apparent over the weekend, where three women were at hospital as a result of being battered. During his rundown of the weekend emergencies, the Assistant Divisional Officer of the St. Lucia Fire Service confirmed that emergency teams responded to a mixed bag of events ranging from vehicular collisions to domestic violence.
The Northern Division of the St. Lucia Fire Service had to respond to three physical assaults on the weekend. Sources told our news desk that at least three women were battered over the weekend, allegedly at the hands of their partners. One of the victims, we were reliably informed, was a pregnant woman. Speaking to Hot 7, the Divisional Officer of the St. Lucia Fire Service, David Antoine, was able to confirm that there were responses to three physical assaults involving women who had to be taken to hospital for care.
The physical assault involved, they were domestic violence, and those persons too were treated and by EMTs and transported to the Victoria Hospital.
Antoine says for legal reasons, the fire service is not able to delve into the details. On the other hand, he indicated that there were a total of 46 responses to calls for assistance. Several people suffered minor injuries due to vehicular accidents.
On the weekend of the 4th to the 7th of January 2019, responded to 46 ambulance calls, of which 40 were medical emergencies, including three physical assaults. Two motor vehicle accidents. The victims of the motor vehicle accidents were checked and stabilized by EMTs before they were subsequently transported to the hospital. The circumstances of these accidents are still being investigated by the St. Lucia Police. We also had one fire call.
The resources of the fire service continue to be strained on weekends. As such, caution has been advised to the general public where hazards are concerned. A special call has gone out to motorists in particular to drive with due care and attention to avoid any carnage on the island's roads.
Police are investigating a break-in at the Lamar building on Bridge Street, Castries, on the floor that houses the Criminal Records Office, the RIT Department, and the Vulnerable Persons Unit. The break-in at all three offices is said to have taken place during the past week. A law enforcement official told an online news agency that intruders are believed to have taken some petty cash and personal effects. The official said no other items appear to have been removed. However, there was an unsuccessful attempt to get into a vault where warrant money is kept. In other news, in the wake of a bombshell expose surrounding the sexual deviance of R&B superstar R. Kelly, activist Fiona Compton, who has become synonymous with her Not Asking For It campaign, is localizing the matter. She's asking St. Lucians to break from the culture of covering up for perpetrators of sexual crimes.
St. Lucian artist and activist Fiona Compton, who is based in London, launched the Not Asking For It campaign to break the culture of victim blaming and to clarify the lines with being responsible for oneself and being at fault if you are attacked. The campaign has gone worldwide, and now with the docu-series Surviving R. Kelly, she says it is important that with this watershed moment, people continue to speak out and shed light on the scourge of sexual violence and abuse. Unfortunately, she says, society still has a long way to go on the issue of ending victim blaming.
Very much enablers in our society, because people say, oh, that's just how fellas are, and you know, whatever, whatever. Or we as women have been made to think you just kind of lie down and take it. And just because you lay down and took it, you know, because just because you're not, it's not some creep in a dark alleyway, you know, that's not rape, but that's not true, you know. And a lot of us are scared because it's people you know. Most cases of sexual assault is someone you know, so therefore someone in your family or a partner or spouse of your family, or it is a friend or someone you went to school with or your neighbor. So you're like, boy, if I open my mouth and say something, this is going to lead me down a road where, you know, for the most part, is the woman that is going to take the blame.
Compton's Not Asking For It campaign was birthed in the wake of the death of a Japanese national and steel pan player in Trinidad and Tobago. She had played for years with the PCS Nitrogen Silver Stars Steel Orchestra in Trinidad. She was killed during the 2016 carnival season. The Port of Spain mayor, who resigned in response to public outrage, made a series of comments about her costume behavior and whether or not alcohol was involved. Compton says that kind of response is all too familiar and all too common. This is why she produces her short, impactful videos as her way of reaching out to today's youth in particular.
I said I had to do something more. So I said, okay, what can I do? What can I do? Because you could do a Facebook post, people will crawl and they'll share and they'll comment, and then it'll be a flash in the pan and finish. So I wanted to do something that's more tangible and long-lasting. And I felt like a lot of the charities and initiatives were kind of felt dated, and they were not contemporary, and they were not something that especially young people could feel that they could relate to, even though they may have been affected by the cause that these initiatives are supporting. I wanted to make it something that's fresh, not necessarily, not fun is not the right word, but something that can really grasp the attention of people. So I decided to just make videos, and you know, the one that did the most successful one was actually our first video, which was like just because, the term just because, was just because I had a drink, just because I'm wearing a skimpy costume, just because, you know, I dance with you. Because the thing is when you speak to a lot of victims, the first question people ask, what were you wearing? What were you drinking? You know, who were you there with? You know, like, okay, so because I had some rum, that means I deserve to be raped.
Compton says victims should never be the ones to bear the burden of guilt for what happened to them. The days of shielding perpetrators, she says, must end.
This is the Hot 7 TV Nightly News. Still to come, a grand theater production to usher in 40 years of independence in style. And officials look to find a solution to the growing problem of traffic congestion. Stay with us. There's more news after the break.